Miss Peretti, please spell syzygy.
Syzygy. S-Y-Z-Y-G-Y? Syzygy?
We have a winner!
Thank you! Thank you! Thank you!
At the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee, my parents keep on telling me, just being here is winning, although I know it isn't so.
But it's a very nice, very, very nice,
very, very nice, very nice beginning.
Our winner here last year, Chip Tolentino, let's give him a hand.
When they announce my name,
Lady Commie Bear,
try to keep from shaking.
Alas, his shaking will not pass.
But it's a very big, very frosty hole, but it's not. It's a very big undertaking.
Returning after last season's tragic setback, William Barfey.
It's pronounced Barfey. There's an accent.
Park. Winner's destination, Washington, D.C.
Plasma TV in a fancy hotel, where they treat you well.
All because you love to sell, please
thank you.
to ask you to please turn off all iPhones, iPads, tablets, Android phones, cell phones, and cameras. Sorry, no photos at the beep. Now, it seems there are three spellers who haven't checked in. So when I call your name, please come up these stairs and meet me at that desk. I'm missing Stephanie Barrett, Brett Floyd, Mark Bowers, and Jill Hildebrand. And I also need to speak with Miss Olive Ostrovsky, please.
I'm Olive!
Olive, it seems we haven't received your entrance fee.
Entrance fee?
Did the school not tell you about the $25 entrance fee? Is your mom here, maybe? Or your dad?
My dad had to go to work. He's gonna try and come later, though.
Who brought you to be here?
The bus!
All right, we'll discuss the entrance fee later. Take your seat.
Marcy, don't be nervous. Just watch what I do.
Don't worry, I'm not nervous.
Have you ever been in an auditorium before?
We've never been in an auditorium before.
What school do you go to?
Shut up!
Gentlemen, the children you see on stage are here because of their extraordinary ability and love of language. But only one of them can go on to compete in the National Spelling Bee. So this year, to celebrate our silver anniversary, our local sponsors, the Putnam Optometrists, are offering today's winner a $200 savings bond towards his or her future education. But remember, to get here, each child had to win.
Oh, but I'm placed.
Or place in their own Putnam Bee. So everyone is already a winner.
Already a winner.
Hello, I'm Annalisa Peretti, and I'm pleased to be back for my ninth consecutive year as your host. Unfortunately, our usual word pronouncer, Superintendent Royer, is stuck on I-25. So please join me in welcoming back Vice Principal Douglas Pant from Lake Hemingway Dos Passos Junior High. Vice Principal Pant is joining us after a 5-year hiatus. So thank you, Douglas, for stepping in on such short notice.
Thank you, Rona. And as to the incident 5 years ago, I'm in a much better place now. It's amazing what a change of diet can do for a man.
Wonderful.
And not only is Ms. Peretti here one of Putnam County's top optometrists, she's also a former spelling champion herself.
Third annual.
Syzygy.
Syzygy, when the earth aligns with the moon and the sun.
Beautiful. And now it's time for the Pledge of Allegiance, led by our comfort counselor, Mr. Mitchell M. Mahoney.
Mr. Mahoney is doing his community service work with us here today.
One nation. Spellers may be seated.
And now for the official spelling bee rules.
A speller.
May ask questions. About the word's pronunciation.
Definition.
Use in a sentence.
In a sentence.
And language of origin.
Language of origin.
If you start to spell a word, you may start over, but the
sequence of the letters already spoken may not be changed.
Moment before the beat.
Schwartz and Grubbery.
Miss Schwartz and Grubbery is head of her Gay Straight Alliance at her elementary school.
The word is strabismus.
Strabismus? May I please have the definition of that word?
Yes. The inability of one eye to obtain binocular vision with the other due to an imbalance of the muscles in the eyeball.
And use it in the sentence, please.
In the schoolyard, Billy protested he wasn't cockeyed. I suffer from strabismus, he said, whereupon the bullies beat him harder.
Notice how she writes on her forearm. This is her way of saying the word before she speaks it out loud. Strabismus, S-T-R-A-B-I-S-M-U-S, strabismus.
That is correct. Mr. Coney Bear.
Mr. Coney Bear was second runner-up of his Putnam Basin District.
Thanks, I got it. Hello, please speaking. Wow, I'm gonna represent the Basin in the B? I can't believe it. Mom, Dad, Miracle, Brooke, Pinecone, Race, and Landscape Hall, you're never gonna believe this.
What's up, Lee?
I made the county finals in the spelling bee.
I know,
but the person who came in first had to go to their bat mitzvah, and the person who came in second had to attend that bat mitzvah, so they called and they want me to do it instead.
You know that the other children will have won their district meets, right?
Well, yeah, but I...
Capybara!
What?
The word is capybara.
Is that a word?
Yes, that's a word.
No way. What does it mean?
It's a tailless, largely aquatic, South American rodent, often exceeding 4 feet in length.
Wow. What else can I ask?
Well, you can ask for a language of origin or for it to be used in a sentence.
I'll have it used in a sentence.
Don't look now, Pedro, but I think that tailless, largely aquatic South American rodent swimming next to you might be a capybara.
Wow. That didn't help at all.
Are you ready to spell the word?
No, but it was fun to come here. My whole family here, which is really... C-A-P-Y. B-A-R-A, capybara.
That is correct.
Miss?
Yes, Miss Ostrowski.
Wow, I can't believe it. I said the first things that came to my head, and now why is it?
Miss Ostrowski came in second in her school's Halloween contest.
I was roadkill.
Ms. Ostrowski, the word is boanthropy.
Boanthropy? May I have the definition, please?
The delusion that one has become an ox.
Oh, ma'am, could you please not sit in that seat?
I saved a chair for my dad in the April on the app. And it may take him. That's his chair. Cause my mother's in an ashram in India. I saved a chair for her too, but it's merely symbolic. As daily she cleanses herself in the Ganges. And I live in a house where there's an oversized dictionary that I read as a girl on the toilet.
Isn't bo the Latin root meaning
And I wrap my head around the fact that in one book is the entire language of our species, which is a favorite term of Nietzsche's, who is the great-grandfather of Christina Ricci's. No, he's not. Yes, I joke, but the words in the dictionary are the friends that'll have forever more than the friends I have made in school. Philanthropy!
Now that I know you have varicosis, honey, those jeans do make you look bad.
B, A, R, A. G-O-N-I-S.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. The correct... It's okay. The correct spelling is B-A-R-A-G-N-O-S-I-S.
P-H-Y-L-A-C-T-E-R-Y. Phylactery.
That is correct.
Slam dunk.
Tolentino.
Charlico Chip Tolentino is a little league pitcher, having a wicked 22 mile per hour screwball.
Is that how you got the cast? We don't need to talk about that. The word is omphalosceptics.
Wait a minute. Didn't Mr. Flores over there get Mexican?
Yes, and you got omphalosceptics.
Those are rated at the same level of difficulty?
Those are both level 1 words, yes.
Omphaloskepsis?
Omphaloskepsis.
Could it be pronounced omphaloskepsis?
It can. It would be wrong.
Omphaloskepsis. O-M-P-H-A-L-A-S-K-E-P-S-I-S. Omphaloskepsis.
That is correct.
He rallied and nailed it. That's what it means to be a champion.
Our next speller, this last name, Jill Hildebrand?
It's Hildebrand.
Oh. Miss Hildebrand is president of her club, Future Gym Teachers of America.
Miss Hildebrand, the word is cow. At the microphone may repeat the word. I am sorry, Miss Hildebrand.
Did you say cow?
I did say
cow. Can I have a definition for that?
Well, it means cow.
Okay. Could you use it in a sentence?
Please spell cow.
That was a great sentence. C O W. Cow.
That is correct.
My oh my.
Broccoli!
I knew that word!
I knew that word!
Miss Schwarzengrubenier.
Miss Schwarzengrubenier has proposed a constitutional amendment lowering the voting age to 10.
The word is cystitis.
Cystitis? May I please have the definition of that word?
An inflammation of the urinary bladder.
And use it in a sentence, please.
Sally's mother told her it was her cystitis that made her special.
Cystitis. I think I studied this one with my dad.
Segway.
S-E-G-U-E.
Good. Siphon.
S-I-T-H-O-N.
Good. Cystitis.
S.
No. Think.
C.
Good.
I.
Logan, are you concentrating?
Yes!
Maybe it's time for a break.
Dan, we're in the middle of a word here.
You know, she doesn't spell when her blood sugar is low, Carl.
What if there's not a break? The beat could last for 3 hours.
Don't you talk. What's more important, her health or the beat?
Daddy conference, now!
No, Dad! Just let me get this one first, please!
We need a spelling now, Logan.
Cystitis. C-Y-S-T-I-T-I-S. Cystitis.
That is correct. Mr. Coney Bear.
Mr. Coney Bear makes his own clothes.
A coochie. That is correct.
I'm might be smart. My siblings can't believe that I got it right. But I got it right. Right? I didn't cheat. I saw this light and it was neat. I like to laugh. I like to spell. I like to never hear the bell. And if this competition's hell, at least I'm finally apart. I feel my heart begin to swell. I love to spell.
That's incorrect. The correct spelling was R-A-G-S-P. Plawger.
A child prodigy, Brent Floyd.
In Braille?
Mr. Bloyd, the word is Fandango.
May I please have a definition?
Yes. A lively Spanish dance for two.
May I please have it in a sentence?
In the song, you know? Okay. I see a little silhouette of a man. Scaramouche, Scaramouche, can you do the Fandango?
Thank you. F-A-N-D-A-G-O? N?
Disappointment can also last like hell.
I just want to beat them up a little so they understand pain has degrees. And this is nothing. This is nothing, you little freaks. Without violent hyperbole. So I do what I can. I give them a hug, a juice box. I'm here to give comfort. Let's go, kid.
Miss Freddy, can I have one more chance, please?
Let's go, kid.
But first on our list.